someone coming into the garage should be seen coming into that window with my wife, upstairs.
He loves me so.
It's your leg coming.
That funny honey of mine.
No, suppose it. If I violated her or something, you know what I mean, right? I violated.
I know what you mean.
Or something. Think about her purple. That could have been, you know?
Now look, I'm gonna tell you the truth. Not that the truth really matters, but I'm gonna tell you anyway.
you know, some guys are like mirrors. When I catch myself in Amos's face, I'm always a kid. You could love a guy like that. But listen, I gotta tell you something, and I hope this ain't too crude, because in the bed department, Amos was a zero. I mean, he made love to me like he was fixing a carburetor or something. I love you, honey. I love you, honey. I love you. Oh! Well, to make the long story short, I started fooling around, and then I started screwing around, which is fooling around without dinner. You see, I gave up on the vaudeville idea because I figured after all those years, the opportunity just passed me by.
Stop! said, right?
Then I
possible moment you can quote me on that.
It's fine! I am the daughter! I'm the father! I'm the father!
Thank you.
truth, Bobby God? I do.
What's he name?
Roxy.
Roxy, you gave me a statement in which you admit to having had illicit relations with the deceased, Fred Casely. Is that statement true or false?
I'm afraid that's true.
Yet you were married, Mrs. Hart.
I know, and I don't think I would have gone with him if Amos and I hadn't quarreled that very morning.
Quarreled? About what?
Oh, Amos, I don't want to work in that cheap Southside nightclub.
Yeah.
And I don't like you working those long hours in the garage either.
Oh, sure.
Oh, Amos, I want a real home and a child.
That's it.
So you drifted into this illicit relationship because you were unhappy at home?
Most unhappy.
Why didn't you stop this affair with Casely?
I tried to, but Mr. Casely, he pleaded and said,
I can't live without you! I can't live without you! I can't live without you!
Roxy Hart, the state has accused you of the murder of Fred Casely. Are you guilty or not guilty?
Not guilty! Not guilty! Oh, I killed him, yes, but I'm not a criminal.
There. Roxy Hart, can you recall the night of February 14th?
Yes, sir.
Tell the jury, in your own way, the happenings of that evening.
Well, it was about 2 a.m., right after work. I stopped in an all-night grocery store to pick up baking powder to make cupcakes for my Amos. Oh, Amos just loved my cupcakes. And then I went right home, and I was getting ready for bed, when all of a sudden, I heard the doorbell go off, and I thought to myself, who could that be? Well, I slipped into my kimono and went to the door, thinking it was my girlfriend, Gloria.
And who was it?
Fred Casely.
And what did he say?
That note you wrote me, telling me it was all over? Why did you write it?
Because I have seen the errors of my ways.
And what did you say?
I said, go away.
Beat it, buddy.
I tried to close the door, but he forced his way in. I ran to the bedroom. But he followed me. Please, no good will come of this. And besides, I love my husband.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
So you told him you loved your husband. What did he say to that?
It doesn't matter. You're mine. You're mine. You're mine.
Oh, I can't go on. I can't go on. I can't go on.
No, Roxy, you must tell the jury everything. They have the right to know.
Well, okay. Amos and I are going to have a baby.
So when you told him you and Amos were going to have a baby, what did he say to that?
I'll kill you before I see you have another man's child.
In his passion, he whipped off my kimono and threw me across the room. Mr. Hartshorn lay there between us. He reached for the gun.
And then,
I knocked it from his hand.
And then?
And then we both reached for the gun. But I got first!
I mean to kill you!
Do you think he meant to kill you?
Oh, yes, sir.
So it was his life or yours?
And not just mine. So I closed my eyes and I shot!
Oh, Roxy! Oh! Roxy, please! Oh!
In defense of your life!
Dazzle, 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 dazzle!
To save my husband!
Isn't it swell? Isn't it?
is proud to announce first, the first time you see in an act of this sort, not one little lady, but two! You've read about them in the papers, those scintillating sinners, those killer dealers, Roxy Hard and Velma Kelly!
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.